Hi, welcome to my world of Newtonian telescopes. For me, my favourite optical instrument.
I'm going to play the Barbarian Hordes with my screwdriver and Allen key, and Ralph Bell here is going to do his best to put it back together. I don't think it could be much worse than that, personally. Nope, you can't see anything at all in there, so that's lovely. There's your Allen key. Do your worst. Well, you didn't want it easy, did you? The Pico Star on its own isn't really bright enough, that the lamp at the front here, the LED, isn't quite bright enough to show up on the camera. So we're going to demonstrate some of the points using a fairly bright light here, and I'm going to put a little cap on it. Ralph's going to sue me because he's...
My night vision's gone completely.
Yeah, his irises have gone down to the size of a millimetre and are going to stay that way now indefinitely.
Today we're going to look at collimating a Smith-Cassegrain telescope. This telescope is now ready for star testing. A laser collimator will get you almost exactly where you need to be, but the final collimation must always be done on the star.
Well, that's interesting, Chelsea.
This is always such a terrific time to observe.
There we are, a nicely collimated telescope, giving us a nice view of the moon.
Job done.
We're here talking about peers today.
Okay, let me get a word in, then we'll do it.
Okay,
Robert. I've had a few mounts over the years.
Peers.
Robert, I've had a few peers over the years. Not been entirely happy with any.
Beers or peers?
Peers. Robert, I've had a few peers over the years. You said beers. You put beers in there.